So a lot of you guys have been requesting me to do show you guys how this one particular mod is made. It's a really simple mod, and I have been personally using this mod for more than 5 years now. Guys, I must tell you, it's really useful, but first thing, you cannot use this in the city. It's very, very dangerous. And if you haven't guessed by now, it is this little thing on my handlebar right here. This little thing. And I call it a throttle lock. A lot of people call it cruise control. It will cost you less than 50 bucks to make this, but it is really, really helpful. So without further ado, hey, what is up, YouTube? You're watching Moto Genesis. And welcome to another one of my videos. Welcome back, you guys. So, as I told you, this mod is fairly inexpensive, but at the same time it's really useful. But once again, you cannot use this in city conditions, because if you somehow manage to not get it back in time, not get control over your motorcycle back in time, you'll end up having an accident. So I strongly suggest don't use this in the city. So I'll show you how this is made, but first let me show you how it works. So as you can see, I'm fairly cruising at a speed of say 57-58, and if I want to continue cruising at this speed, I speed up a little bit towards 60. And if you can see, this thing has come up with my accelerator. So all I have to do is push it forward to a point where it touches my brake lever and let it go. As you can see, my speed is constant between 60 to 62. Now, unlike traditional cruise control, the speed will vary because you're going uphill, downhill. Roads are never even. But if they are even, you'll hold a speed for more or less like 10-15 minutes. And after that, you'll notice a steep decline in speed. But right now, as you can see, I'm going easily around 60, 59, 65, somewhere between the 55 to 65 range, and that's pretty good on the highway. So that's how this thing works. If you want to stop it, all you have to do is you just push your accelerator forward, and that's it. It disengages. So next time you pull up your accelerator like I have right now, this thing comes up with it again. So it's a really easy mod. You can go like 10-15 minutes without having to keep your hand on the accelerator on an open highway, and that really helps on long rides. So let's quickly go and see how this is made. I'll see you back at home. Welcome back at home, guys. So all you're gonna need for this mod is a screwdriver, negative screwdriver, and this is called a hose clamp. Available for 30-35 rupees at any hardware store. So all you have to do is turn this screw anti-clockwise, like so, enough for this entire hose clamp to open up like that. And then see, as I have this, I cannot just slide it in. But if you don't have a handguard, you can just slide it out from the side. You don't have to open it up, but I have to open it up because I have a handguard. Now what you want to do is, as you close this thing will start showing up on this side, so that has to face the lever. So all you do is wrap it up like this. Okay, so this goes that side towards the lever, and you stick it back in, hold it there, and turn this clockwise. So as you could have guessed by now, this is going to take a while, so I'll just show you how it's done on this. This is already ready. So let me just... Okay, so as you can see, that this part will stick out from here like this. This is the screw. I've just covered it up in some tape. So yeah, let me refocus. Like that, and you have to have it tight enough for it to hold, but not so tight that when you try to disengage it, it shouldn't come up or bend. If you make it too tight, this thing will bend and break off. So it has to be slightly flexible, but not too tight, but not too loose either. So to check whether it's good enough, you engage it like so and turn it around. You see how this didn't move?
Because if it moves in with the accelerator, this will bend and break off. So it has to be like that. You push it forward and see how it holds its place. That's how tight it should be. It should have a little gap. I don't know if you can see, there's a little gap there. And that's pretty much it, guys. I've covered it up with M-seal and tape because this is very sharp and it tends to rust over time. So you can get cuts on your fingers. That's why you should also wrap it up. And that's it. That's how it's done. It's super easy. It takes less than 10 minutes. I'll see you back on the road.
Welcome back, guys. So I hope I've explained it well enough. I try my best normally to explain it as much as possible, but even then, if you have any questions or if you didn't get enough clarity from the video, you can ask me in the comment section below. And if you want to discuss something regarding this video or any other video or anything else in general, you can hit me up on Instagram. I'll leave my Instagram ID in the description box. I generally tend to reply to all messages and I do get a lot of messages, but be sure I'll reply at some point of time. And we can have a chat there. I love having a chat with my subscribers and my viewers. So I'll see you either in the comment section below or on Instagram. That's pretty much it, guys. Really helpful mod for me. I've been using it on all my motorcycles across 5 years. And I hope this helps you guys out too. Bye-bye.